Hey guys, you want to know how to have this nice telephone effect on your voice in your live stream on YouTube, but without using any additional streaming software? Then hang in there, we'll tell you how that works after the intro.
For this use case, you don't need to buy expensive equipment or software. The only thing you need is an ESI product, like this wonderful USB microphone cosMik uCast. All the audio software I'll talk about in this video is included with the mic, so it comes to you for free. So let me show you how the setup works. At first, I want to give my voice this nice telephone effect. To do that, I need an audio software. All these programs here are part of the free software bundle of the cosMik uCast, and we'll pick Bitwig Studio 8-track. Make sure to follow the instructions on this postcard to download and install Bitwig Studio 8-track on your computer. Also make sure to download and install the driver for your cosMik uCast USB microphone, otherwise you won't have access to the DirectWIRE functionality, and we'll need that later for streaming. Please note that DirectWIRE does only work on a Windows computer or laptop. So if you are a Mac user, you can still watch this video if you want to know how to create this nice telephone effect, but you won't be able to stream your altered voice unless you use any other extra loopback software or something. Alright, so here is our control panel. We'll turn that wheel a bit for the monitoring. The input gain and the output volume can both be adjusted using the knobs on the front of the mic. Now we head over to Bitwig. Create a new project. Click on the audio section. It could be that Bitwig recognizes your microphone as input already. If not, then go to Audio Inputs and then add Buses. Choose the ASIA driver and as device the cosMik uCast. Then you can add a mono channel and set a check mark under the 1 to define where your signal comes from. And if you like, you can rename the entry into cosMik uCast. That can make life easier if you end up adding different sources later. The output buses should be set on 1-2. That's gonna be important in a few minutes, so don't forget it. Now close the dialog and your settings will be saved. Now we want to alter the sound of our voice. To do that, select your audio track and click on the plus symbol down here. Now select the EQ5. A telephone sound is characterized by the lack of low and high frequencies, but the overpresence of the mids. And that's why we kind of cut the lows right here. So click on the 1 and hit high pass 4 pole, and we'll drag that a bit to the right, so everything under 500 Hz is cut off. Same applies for the 2. We do a similar thing with the high frequencies. We choose the low pass 4 pole for number 5 and drag that over to something like 1.4 or 5. To give the mids more presence, we'll play around a bit with the numbers 3 and 4 until we finally manage to create something like this little hill.
Okay, here we are. This is our telephone sound.
Now we want to set up our live stream, so we head over to our YouTube channel. On the right corner, you see the Go Live button up here, so simply hit that button. Don't worry, you won't go live right away. First, you'll have the opportunity to prepare your live stream, and this is how that looks like. Okay, let's go through this real quick. Let's give it a title and a description. And right here you can pick whatever suits you best. Now you could upload a thumbnail here if you prepared something. If not, you'll get the chance to take a shot with your webcam later. We don't want to add this to a playlist. It's not made for kids, but there is also no age restriction. If you are planning to do a swear words competition or something, make sure to adjust settings right here. This section is about the audience. You can allow everyone or just your subscribers to participate in a live chat. And you can tick slow mode. That makes it easier for everyone to follow the thousands of comments posted during your livestream. Now, this is about the visibility. If you want to practice first before you really go live in front of an audience, make sure to choose private, otherwise you can go public. You can schedule your stream, but we want to go live right now. Now simply hit done. And you'll be forwarded to the stream preview. And as I said before, you are getting the chance to take a very nice shot and use this one as thumbnail right now. If you don't want to do that, YouTube will simply use your profile picture. But yeah, we'll just do this. Now, listen up, because this is going to be important. In this preview, you can manage the camera input, webcam is fine for us, and the microphone input. This section is very important. This is where we pick channel 3, 4, and before we move on here on YouTube, we head over to the DirectWIRE window. To do that, just open the control panel, hit DirectWIRE, and now we want to link the signal that is being played out in Bitwig to the input that YouTube uses. So this is our wiring. Why is that? Because on the Asia side, Bitwig plays out the sound of my whole performance on channel 1, 2. Remember, this is what I said a few minutes ago, output 1, 2. And I want to send this signal to YouTube, which, as a web service, uses WDM-MME. On YouTube, I have just decided to go for the channels 3, 4, so I have to do the same in my wiring. Now hit mix 3, 4, 2, 1, 2, so you will be able to hear your own signal as well. And that's it! Now it's time to go live. And during your performance, you can even turn the telephone effect on and off again.
That's it. I hope that was useful for you. If so, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll say,
see you in the next video. Bye.